last talk for today's session, we will be listening to Professor Michal Křížek's talk, A Critical Review of Paradoxes in the Special Theory of Relativity.
Okay, thank you very much. I would like to start with this picture from the famous Gamow book. And here is some man who is cycling speed maybe 80% of light. And according to Gamow, he should see everything, according to this formula, which represents contractions of length. But I would like to show you that if you take into account finite speed of light and which leads to Doppler phenomenon and also aberration effects, then for instance this policeman will be not thin but much fatter, yes? So this is the contents of my lecture. So I will speak about time dilatation, then I ask you some question about relativistic Doppler phenomenon, Lorentz transformation, length contraction, and I'll give you some examples. So we show that the Doppler effect and aberration of light can produce more dominant and entirely opposite effects for relativistic speeds than those predicted by the special theory of relativity, namely dilatation, time dilatation and length contraction. For instance, an observer will measure a higher frequency of an approaching clock than the same clock has at rest. We also prove that under certain conditions, an approaching bar on a photo may seem to have a larger length for relativistic speed than at rest. So it is completely opposite. So we shall consider standard coordinate system. This contains synchronized clock. This means that all clocks in the space show the same time, yes? This means that they would be synchronized by infinite speed of the signal. And the coordinate system is called inertial if it obeys Newton's first law of motion. And then I shall have another system, x prime, y prime, z prime, which moves by constant speed v. All these axes have uniform scale, the same scale. And the speed of this system S prime will be in this interval. This means open interval. So the basic postulate of special theory of relativity says that the speed of light C has the same size in all inertial systems. It was verified by Michelson. Then I introduce the standard Lorentz factor. Everybody knows that. This is always greater or equal than one. And what is important that when I have two systems, one system is here and another here, and when they when the origins of these systems say collide, then I start then I put t equal to zero and t prime equal to zero. Then in this special case the Lorentz transformation has the following form. So this formula is here, this formula is here, and these do not change. So first say observation that the time may depend not only on t but also on x, on the position, was already found by Lorentz in this paper, La théorie électromagnétique de Maxwell et son application au corps mouvement. And it was published much earlier than Einstein has. It has almost 200 pages. And Einstein, he, in his very famous paper, which has almost the same title, yes, if you translate it, it is almost the same, he does not quote Lorentz. It is interesting, but Moreover, Lorentz was very famous at that time because he got the Nobel Prize in 1902, just after Rengen. Yeah? So it, I think he knew about it, but at that time Einstein was 26 years old and he didn't know which are the rules when he published this famous paper. So here you can see that this is constant, this Lorentz factor, so there is some constant, and V is also constant, C square is constant, so there is also constant. So this is linear, say, mapping, this is also linear mapping, so if it is linear, then you can write it as in a matrix form, so Lorentz transformation can be written in this form, where this corresponds to x, this corresponds to time, and these two corresponds to y and z axis. Here I, instead of t, I included c because then you measure in meters. Every component is measured in meters. The inverse Lorentz transformation has a similar form as that one. You only put here plus. It is very easy to check it. And Lorentz transformation is a one-to-one mapping. This means bijective mapping from four-dimensional space into four-dimensional space. Some guy asked me, what about Lorentz transformation on, if you have, say, light cone. No, it is not valid, because if you are on the light cone, then this V is C at the same time. So this ratio is one. No, and here you have gamma minus gamma, and here minus gamma, gamma. So you see that these two rows are dependent, and if they are dependent, this matrix is, of course, is singular. This means there is no one-to-one mapping. Yeah? So it Lorentz transformation collapses on a light cone. So now I will very briefly show you how to derive this formula for time dilatation. So if you take t1 prime and t2, and this will be two space independent coordinates in S prime. Then for an arbitrary fixed point x in system S, we determine the corresponding t1 and t2 such that this formula, this means that formula, holds for I equal to 1 and 2. So this x is fixed. And now you only subtract these two numbers and we define delta t prime in this way. And you see that these two terms cancel, and you end up with that. So it is very, you get very simple formula for time dilatation. So according to special theory of relativity, the clock at rest is fastest. So there are several, say, experiments how to say verify whether it is true or not. Some of them are based on the so-called transverse Doppler phenomenon. There are also such experiments that there were three clocks. One was at Earth, it stayed, and one was sent by airplane in one direction and another clock in another direction. And after, say, after several hours, they checked what is the difference. But I think that this experiment is not too credible, since none of the corresponding three systems was inertial. Yes, none was inertial because Earth rotates, so it is. And say relative error was 10 to the minus 15, so it is very difficult to check such a thing. So now I will present very simple example. So let us consider the speed, 80% of the speed of light, and its proper time will pass slower than on the clock fixed in the system S due to this formula. So if you substitute this V to here, you end up that you will see that it is 5 over 3 delta T. And now I have investigative questions to you. So assume that this is our observer, which sits at the origin of the system S, there is Z-axis, yes, and he has very precise watch, atomic watch, yes, and assume that he does not know anything about theory of relativity, yes, he just didn't visit any courses. And now if I take another clock which is synchronized, yes, so the question is, will he observe that it ticks faster, slower, or equally? So assume that this clock is approaching very at the same speed, at the uniform speed, constant speed. So people usually say, no, it is slower because of this formula, but it is not so, because we have a Doppler phenomenon, and Doppler phenomenon is much bigger than time dilatation. So I will now show you how it works. So in fact, it is blue shift, not, this is red shifted and this is blue shifted, yes? And this blue shift is more stronger phenomenon. So Christian Doppler, when he was in Prague, he had very famous lecture here about, light of, binary stars, color life of binary stars, and he derived such a formula for the change of frequencies, the speed of light. This is not the speed of light. It can be speed in the some medium, but in our case it will be speed of light, and there is relation how the observed frequency will look like. But we have to include this formula, the dilatation of time, and if you do some substitutions, so for instance here this red formula, this is exactly that formula, because this is frequency, this is time, so 1 over frequency is time, so therefore you have here gamma to minus 1. And if you do substitutions, you end up with such a, this is called Doppler relativistic formula for the change of frequency. So now, theorem, for V in between 0 and C, you always have, if you divide this FV, this is this Doppler velocity, by F prime, so it is greater than VF divided by F, and it is always greater than 1. And moreover, if V tends to C, speed of light, then this ratio tends to infinity. This means that the Doppler phenomenon is much stronger than dilatation of time. And it is very easy to prove this theorem, because if you take the and substitute to this Doppler formula, then if V tends to C, then here this tends to 1, and 1 minus 1 is 1, so here in fact, here in the denominator you have 2, and here in limit you have 0, so you see that this F is much bigger than that, and for our concrete data, you see that this observer will see 3 times higher frequency than this clock has. Yes, yeah? So he will see 3 times bigger, 3 times quicker tick of this clock. And if you substitute here V equal to 90% of speed of light, then you get here 1 plus 9 divided by 0.1, and you get that this ratio between these two frequencies is even 10. So he will see 10 times quicker clock. So the higher the speed v, the greater is the Doppler effect. Therefore, it is therefore very important to distinguish consistently between reconstructions. This means calculations by means of the Lorentz transform and observations. This means measurements, photographs, videos. In my opinion, the term in the notion observer in the special theory of relativity is somewhat confusing. It should not be a person who just substitutes here some values and calculates. It should be a person who does real observation and measurements, including all effects together, including Doppler phenomenon, aberration of light, and so on. So in my opinion, observer is what he really observes and not the guy who just calculates the Lorentz transformation. I would only briefly recall that Einstein became famous because of this formula how to add velocities. It is relatively simple to say prove it. You can find the proof in these pink proceedings. I can also easily prove that Lorentz transformation for all V form an abelian group. This means commutative group. You just verify all axioms of a group. For instance, if you have two matrices, then they usually do not commute, but they have such a special block form that they commute these matrices. So therefore, this group is abelian, and due to because multiplication of matrices is associative operation, then also it forms a group. So now let me go to lens contraction. So we have on the horizontal axis we have considered some point x prime. We have fixed bar which is at rest in the system S prime, and we denote x prime this difference. And very similarly, these formulas are almost the same. We get again that x prime is equal to gamma times delta x, which is this formula. And usually contractions of lengths is expressed by this famous formula. So the bar at rest has the greatest length. But now I will show you that if I take camera and I will make photo of such a bar, then I can get completely different situation than this statement. So consider the bar which has length 1 meter, and again assume that it moves with relativistic speed 80% of light. So then according to this formula for contraction, you find easily that this formula will be, reduced only to 60 centimeters. So first guy who find that it is maybe not true was John Singer, and he inspired Roger Penrose. And Penrose in 1958 wrote a paper that the apparent shape of a relativistic moving sphere could be again the sphere. And later Terrell wrote invisibility of Lorentz transformation. The main idea of this Penrose example is the following. So if you have some ball which moves in this direction, so according to this formula, it should be not ball but ellipsoid. But due to, aberration of light and finite speed of gravity, this photon will leave this this ball here. When then this ball moves, and when it is, when this point is here, then this photon is already here, and then they have the same same distance to the camera, or what is this eye? So this is in his paper, this is in his book, Road to Reality, but the main idea is already in his paper, that you can see the ball if it moves by relativistic speed and that it looks again like a ball. So I will now show you very simple example. Instead of ball, I will use also only this bar, yes? So we already know that this bar, this 1 meter bar, is say reduced only to 60 centimeters if it has this speed. And therefore AD, this is 0.4 meters. And now assume that this camera is 75 centimeters from this axis X. So if it is so, then this this is right triangle, this is also right triangle, so this segment to that segment is the same as that segment to that segment. And you find that this the length of this segment is 30 centimeters, and from that you find that from A to B it is half a meter. So this means that this is the length of this big triangle. This is 1 meter. This is 0.5. So by Pythagorean theorem, it is 1.25 minus AB. AB, we know that this is half a meter. So you get that this is exactly D. So this distance is the same as that distance. So if the bar moves, then the photon which leaves the rear end of this bar will come to point B, and during that time the front end of this bar will reach the origin, and this is the same distance, yes? So in this way you can find that you will see no contraction. So there are some assumptions because you should have say some idealized camera which can take pictures every picosecond, because during 1 picosecond light will fly only 0.3 millimeters, so a possible blurring will be not significant. And maybe I will go to another slide. So I have chosen this example so that this is standard Pythagorean triangle 3, 4, 5. So in this special example, the bar will have the same length on the photograph and also in when it is fixed. So now we will move this camera closer to this axis. If you put it closer to this axis, you can again use Pythagorean theorem, and you will end up with, this is the Pythagorean theorem, and you will end up with formula for D, which is expressed by the length of this original bar and so on. So it is possible to find that in this case this D is, if it is 26 centimeters, then you will see on your camera the bar which has 2 meters, yes? So if this camera will be here approximately, then 1 meter bar on photograph will have 2 meters. So it is longer. It is in detail calculated in these proceedings. And if it is only 4 centimeters from x-axis, the bar will have 4 meters. It is nonlinear, of course, everything is very nonlinear. So you may say that the bar was asymmetric here. This is asymmetric, yes? So let us put the bar symmetrically. This is 60 centimeters, this is also 60 centimeters. But as I already told you, if I would put this camera, so altogether this bar has now 2 meters. 1 meter here, 1 meter here, but it is reduced by this formula. So it will have 60 plus 60. But if you put this camera to this 26 centimeters from origin, then, as I already told you, you will see the 1 meter bar, that it is 2 meters. So already that left part will be 2 meters and you have something on the right. So it is more than the original bar, yes? So on camera you will see completely opposite effect than that. And this is due to the finite speed of light and Doppler phenomenon and aberration of light. So this is another picture from the book by Gamow, this book. And this gentleman, according to this formula, should see this bicycle reduce in this direction. But as I already told you, if you see bar, which can be of the same size or even longer, this, if the speed is sufficiently high, you should see longer bicycle than that. The bicycle, my bicycle is 1.75 meters, so you could see, for instance, 3 long meters bicycle on camera. This gentleman should see it. Moreover, he should not see those wheels like ellipses, yes? Because in fact those points which are here, they do not move, while these are in say Newtonian mechanics, they would have double speed. And moreover, these say wires are not, they should be not straight but bended. There are many effects, yes? In this paper, there is how can you see the moving cube, which is also interesting, that you can see the cube in this way. And now conclusions. So special relativity has a number of unexpected claims that contradict our intuition. And according to the special theory of relativity, no experiment can be made to decide whether the body is at rest or moving. All inertial systems for describing physical phenomena are equivalent, and there is no preferred inertial system. However, nowadays we know that maybe some preferred system is cosmic microwave background, because if we say move in this direction, on that direction, we can find some, say, optimal velocity so that you see completely homogeneous cosmic microwave background. Moreover, in the limiting case, the Einstein formula gives such a velocity, so does every photon has a speed of light in any inertial system. And many books claim that for small velocities, The standard Galileo transformation reduces to Lorentzian transformation. But in this paper, Two Myths About Special Relativity, the author finds that it is not true, yes? Because this is the relation for time dilatation. And now assume that the speed is arbitrarily small but constant. So if this is fixed, then you always can find x sufficiently large that this term dominates over that term, yes? So we always can find x such that the term will be much bigger than that term. So it is not true that Galileo transformation for small speeds reduces to that, because if your x is very far from the origin, it is not true. But if c is considered as a parameter and c tends to infinity, then this transformation changes to that transformation. So we conclude by stating that the longitudinal Doppler effect and aberration of light may cause that we observe completely opposite phenomena than those predicted by the special theory of relativity. So thank you very much for your attention.